John, vas arribar alcalde de Reykjavík després d'una campanya i amb un partit, podríem dir, de broma, el millor partit. Per què el crees, el millor partit?
I was working as a playwright in the city theater and I was writing a play about the crisis. Suddenly I had this idea, how about in taking media, politics and the financial sector onto the stage, how about taking the stage to the media? You know, I wanted to create a spectacle.
Però tenia alguna cosa a veure amb la crisi que vivia en aquell moment el país?
Yeah, it was right after the collapse of the big banks, and it was a lot of confusion, anger, aggression and fear. And people were protesting every day and throwing beer bottles at the police and attacking parliament. And I just wanted, you know, to do something different. Use my anger in a creative way.
I els altres candidats què et deien?
Yeah, I mean, in the beginning, it was a joke, you know, everybody was like laughing with me. It's like, ha, 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 yeah, and here is Jón. What does Jón have to say about this issue? but found themselves to be humiliated. Yeah.
Per què?
Because I was a clown and behaving like a clown. And people were going to vote for me instead of them. So it was a, yeah. And it was like established, respectable political parties losing elections to a comedian.
En el programa electoral amb què et vas presentar hi havia alguna proposta, si em permets, una mica absurda, com aquella de Disneyland. Vas arribar a complir alguna d'aquestes promeses?
Yeah, I just wanted to exaggerate it, to ridicule it, to let people see. You know, you can promise whatever. You know, I can promise anything, and especially because I promised that I would break all my promises anyway, because that's what politicians do, and that's also, you know, what religion does. I promised Disneyland. I promised a polar bear. Mm-hmm. I promised a drug-free parliament 2020. So I'm still working on that.
Però i a ningú li va semblar frívol aquest tipus de plantejament en plena crisi financera? Hi havia gent que ho passava malament, segur.
One of the main slogans of the best party was all sorts for the unfortunate, like all sorts for the unfortunate, and hooray for all sorts of things, and underdogs, like God bless underdogs, and people were saying, who are the underdogs? And I would say, you were all underdogs.
Al llarg dels 4 anys que vas ser alcaldia, què vas fer per la ciutat?
When the best party, you know, we gave birth to this spectacle that had never been before. And I decided, okay, I'm going to take responsibility. I played with the idea of moving to Costa Rica.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah, to going to Costa Rica and just stay there for 3 years or something. but I didn't do it. The first thing I had to work on as mayor in the city was, you know, to make a budget for the city. And that was something I was absolutely not prepared for. I wanted a polar bear, you know, and some, you know, fun.
Era un partit de dretes o d'esquerres, el millor partit?
I guess it would be considered a left wing. Liberal, very liberal left wing. So it's light anarchism.
L'anarquisme pot ser light?
It was, in a sense, it was a surrealist movement. Like political surrealism, surrealism is in nature very political.
Per què vas demanar als socis, als socialdemòcrates, que es miressin The Wire?
If you were on the news, you were very important. And I wanted to be on the news. So I was asked on the news, you know, if I had thought about who I would work, collaborate with, who I would form a majority with. And I used that opportunity to tell people about The Wire. And I said, well, I will definitely not work with somebody who hasn't watched The Wire. And it was, it worked. People were watching The Wire all over, and it's a good show.
Quina factura personal van tenir aquests 4 anys a l'alcaldia de Reykjavik per tu?
I was burned out. I was absolutely exhausted, and people were, I was really popular, and people were hoping that I would run again and continue to be mayor, and I didn't want to do it, you know, and it was affecting my physical and mental health. In reality, something I didn't intend for, you know. I wanted to make a point, you know, I wanted to make a funny spectacle that everybody would admire and say, wow, that was an amazing spectacle, like fireworks or something, and then it would be over, but it wasn't over. And it took me a long time to recover from it.
No ho trobes a faltar?
No. No.
Això t'ha fet canviar l'opinió sobre els polítics? Els admires ara, potser?
Maybe not, I mean, admire, yes, in a way. Like, unlike many people, I have deep respect, for instance, for Angela Merkel. I have deep respect for that woman. Politicians in general are like all other people. I mean, most of them are okay people. Some of them are corrupt, and some of them are lazy, and some of them are just, you know, alcoholics. And that's just, you know, how life is. And
creus que el millor partit es podria exportar a altres països? Per exemple, a Espanya funcionaria?
Yeah, absolutely. The best party, the concept of the best party could happen anywhere. And I think we will, you know, it would help if we would be able to experiment with, you know, to use the best party.
John, moltes gràcies.
Thank you. Muchas gracias.